One famous local case is Roger Foley, seen here in hospital, clearly suffering the effects of the severe neurodegenerative disease he's had since 2015.
So, Mum, I'm going to play you an audio clip. The recording's a bit rough, I'm afraid. We're going to listen to this.
Roger secretly recorded the discussion with hospital staff about his potential home care package.
If I had self-directed funding, then I'd be fine, but...
But if you weren't, you can just apply to get an assisted. If you want it in your life, you don't have to do it in some dramatic manner. You can apply for assisted,
Well, they already presented the outcome option to me, but it's like, why force me to end my life when...
No, hang on here. I'm saying, if you feel that way, don't get me wrong. I'm saying, I don't want you to be here and wanting to take your life in some... If you're having any thoughts, because you always have any thoughts.
Well, because I'm trapped. It's my intolerable suffering is due to the system creating it.
Yeah.
Well, what do you think?
I definitely don't think that offering an assisted death is the right response in a conversation about what kind of care package they're asking.
Yeah, I'm sure that the doctors who were talking to him about that were well-intentioned, but they're at the back of their minds is, this man is clogging up a bed he doesn't actually need because he could be at home. It might be they called him in because he sounds like he's suicidal. He's feeling very, very depressed.
Yeah.
As he explains, that's because he can't get out of the hospital with the care that he needs. Yeah. Not because he wants to die, he wants to live.
But they're calling in the wrong person, aren't they?
Yeah.
If he's feeling suicidal, they should have the anti-suicidal team looking after him.
Someone was alerted to, this guy's suicidal. So they think, we'll send in the maid assessor, rather than send in the suicide prevention team.
Exactly.
And what a catastrophe. They might have well sent in someone with a syringe.